Hi Briman, in this video I'm going to explain how to generate a 100 random integers in between the range 1 to 100 and how to store them in an array and display the contents on console. And here we are trying to write this program in three versions of using different loops. So in C programming language we have three types of loops are available. So that is while, do while and for loops. So we'll see how we can implement the random numbers between 1 to 100 by using three different types of loops in this program. So before I'm going to explain this program, I want to show you what do you mean by random numbers. So random numbers are the numbers that occurs in a sequence such that it can met two conditions. The first one is the values are uniformly distributed over a defined intervals or a set. And the second condition is it is impossible to predict a future value based on the past or present ones. So random numbers are very important in statistical analysis and probability theory. So now we'll see how to implement the logic for generating the random numbers between 1 to 100. So here these are two header files I declared in my program. So one is hash include stdio.h and the second one is hash include stdlib.h. So stdio.h is used to recognize my printf and scanf statements in my program. And now coming to hash include stdlib.h is used to recognize my random function which I am used later in my program. So now this is my main function. So in that main function I am declaring three variables. N is for taking the choice and I can use the later in my loops. So that is in my while and do while loops. So I can initialize my I value with 1 because I want to start to generate a values from 1 to 100. So I can start my loops with 1 and I can end with 100. So I am declaring one more array, that is A of 100 of type integer. So which can hold maximum of 100 numbers. So before I'm going to implement the logic by using for while and do while. So I just ask the user for entering the choice. So in printf statement, enter your choice between 1 to 3. By using scanf, I try to read that integer value. And this is my switch case. Here why I am using switch case is I have three choices. Either I can generate a random number by using for loop or by while loop or do while loop. So because of that I have a choice in my program. So in C program the switch cases allows you to implement such type of situations. So for that here I am using switch case. In that switch I passed my n value because it will take the case. So if the user entered 1, then it will take switch of 1, then simply it switches to case 1. If user entered value is 3, then simply it takes 3 as value and it's try to switch the case 3. So like that switch case will work. So this is a syntax we have to follow. So switch, case and break, these three are the keywords which is available in your C programming. So now in case 1, so before I am going to generate my random numbers between 1 to 100 using for loop, I just want to print these things on my screen. So it will show me like display the random numbers between 1 to 100 using for loop. So after that, I can write my for loop I equals to 0 and I is less than 100 I plus plus. So from 0 to 99, you have totally 100 elements. So now your index it starts from A of 0 and it ends with A of 99. So totally it can hold 100 numbers. So now simply this is a logic 1 plus rand of modulus of 99. So here I am using this logic to generate the random numbers. And after that, after generating each and every random number, I try to print that value by using this printf statement. So here see printf percentile d because the random number is generated as an integer and it takes a position. So in first iteration I is 0, now it will take and print A of 0 position element. After your I increments and the condition satisfy, then 1 less than or equal less than 100 condition satisfy, again it will generate the second random number and it will place at position A of 1. So like that, the loop, it will execute it for 100 times. After the 100th iteration, so your I is becomes to 100. So when I becomes to 100, so 100 less than 100, the condition failed. So when this condition